to explore how to worship together in these strange times. And as you may have noticed last week, the new norm is adding masks to worship. So I hope you are enjoying not needing a mask at home. But we are trying to do this as safely as we can. And both the county health officials and the bishop have asked that when we're not speaking or singing, that we wear masks to be as safe as we can. Everything that you need for our worship this morning is available in the bulletin, which is on the homepage of our website. I bet someone will drop it in the comments now if you still need it. And if you'd rather join in singing the hymns from your own hymnal, the numbers should be marked there in the bulletin as well. Thank you for being with us. We're going to take a deep breath and enter in through silence and the bell. Thank you.
They would sell their possessions and goods and distribute the proceeds to all, as any had need. Day by day, as they spent much time together in the temple, they broke bread at home and ate their food with glad and generous hearts, praising God and having the goodwill of all the people. And day by day, the Lord added to their number those who were being saved. Hear what the Spirit is saying to God's people.
according to John.
Glory to you, Lord Christ.
Jesus said, "Very truly I tell you, anyone who does not enter the sheepfold by the gate, but climbs in by another way, is a thief and a bandit. The one who enters by the gate is the shepherd of the sheep. The gatekeeper opens the gate for him, and the sheep hear his voice. He calls his own sheep by name and leads them out. When he has brought out all his own, he goes ahead of them, and the sheep follow him because they know his voice. They will not follow a stranger, but they will run from him because they do not know the voice of strangers." Jesus used this figure of speech with them, but they did not understand what he was saying to them. So again, Jesus said to them, "Very truly I tell you, I am the gate for the sheep. All who came before me are thieves and bandits, but the sheep did not listen to them. I am the gate. Whoever enters by me will be saved, and will come in and go out and find pasture. The thief comes only to steal and kill and destroy. I came that they may have life and have it abundantly." The Gospel of the Lord. Folks are exhausted. This is the refrain that I am hearing again and again right now. Exhausted from the challenge or maybe the impossibility of working and homeschooling in the same place at the same time. Exhausted from the worry about one's own health or about our loved ones or about our kin all around the world. Exhausted watching bills pile up without paychecks. Trying to figure out what necessities to prioritize. Again, impossibly hard. Exhausted from isolation, from boredom, from massive uncertainty. Not everyone is in this place, and if you are feeling great, I am really happy for you. But to all you listening who are spent, I see you. I hear you. You are in very good company. Jesus' words today are a strange addition to this almost ubiquitous exhaustion. It always takes some work to translate the shepherding metaphors to our context, so far removed as we are from those literally pastoral ways of life. And especially now, we are not wandering in the fields, getting lost. We're closed in at home. Whatever gates we can find already holding us in as we shelter. Into this void, Jesus comes with promises that can be as confusing now as they were then. and nourishment, rest. And then there's this other part to his promise. In this vision, he promises that his sheep will recognize his voice, that they will follow as they hear him calling them by name. Have you ever spent time with sheep? When I was in high school, we lived right next door to a field full of sheep, and my experience is that on the whole, they are not very smart. They get lost easily. They get stuck in comically simple places, sometimes the very same place again and again and again. And yet, Jesus trusts the flock, trusts that we will hear and listen and follow. Even though right here in this passage, the people listening to him have not gotten it right. Here in and among the disciples are the community leaders who, when Jesus has just healed the man born blind, these leaders reject him, don't believe him, kick him out. And still, Jesus trusts that they will follow. He doesn't show frustration that we are of little faith, or call us a brood of vipers here, or lament that we cannot stay awake and watch with him for an hour. He's just confident that somehow we'll get it, that we'll join him, that we'll be able to follow. His trust in us is part of the promise. But it doesn't come haphazardly, by accident. I think this confidence comes precisely because of the kind of life he leads us into. Let me show you. Last year, I came across the work of a bishop who I'd never heard of before. Her name is Tricia Hersey. She's a black woman living in Atlanta. And she has claimed the pastoral title of the Nap Bishop. Nap, as in taking a short rest in the middle of the day. As the Nap Bishop, she's leading a remarkable and subversive ministry there in the city of Atlanta and all around the country. Fittingly, it is named the Nap Ministry. A theologian and poet and performance artist and activist, the Nap Bishop is taking the countercultural notion of rest in the face of the grind and hallowing it, insisting on it. She gathers people to perform this rest publicly and gorgeously, naming rest as both art and necessity. In word and image, she publishes the beauty and the necessity of rest lavishly and unapologetically. A core part of her work is condemning the very system that prizes rest as off limits, as a luxury for so many people. She sees the order that demands the nonstop race to do more. And defiantly, prophetically, she presses pause. The Nap Bishop calls the question deep in our bodies. The way that she is leading? This, friends, this is the way of the Good Shepherd. To the best of my knowledge, Hersey is the only Nap Bishop. And it's a rather uncommon task. rest as a beautiful and sacred act? What if you claimed Jesus' image of the protected, safe haven of the sheepfold and followed him there also? What bit of the constant grind can you set down in order to fit through the gate and find respite? What can you press pause on so that you can rest today? Things may be out of control for a long time yet. The systems that theoretically make life doable, schools and childcare, nursing homes that we can actually visit, places of entertainment and connection, these may be off limits for quite a while. But that
bring your peace to this world and to our own land. God of life,
hear our prayer.
Your Son appeared to Mary Magdalene when she was weeping. Comfort those who are suffering, lonely, or grieving, especially those on our parish prayer list and those we nominate aloud.
May the peace of the risen Christ be always with you.
And also with you.
Walk in love as Christ loved us and gave himself for us, an offering and sacrifice to God. Thank you. see. Many thanks for Colleen's beautiful music. And indeed, Phil's your birthday. Fantastic. And Jeff and Michelle are celebrating their 29th anniversary tomorrow. David Dawson's birthday was yesterday, and Lori's birthday is this week. And Jeff and Patty were married 33 years ago yesterday. And quick to see more of that. Pat is thankful that she was able to help an 87-year-old cousin find out who her father is. How beautiful. All right. Let us pray. God, we give you thanks for the gift of music, for this gorgeous way of praying twice, and for Colleen's gift of leadership and teaching and guiding us in that way. We give you thanks for Phil, for his good humor and calm leadership in trying times. We give you thanks for love shown so clearly in people coming together to share their lives, for Jeff and Michelle, for Patty and Jeff, for that trust and the adventure of sharing life fully. God, we give you thanks for David, for the new life that is unfolding in the excitement of more time together and even in these uncertain times. Lord, we give you thanks for Lori, for all she does to keep us looking towards what is holy, one with another. And God, we give you thanks for the wonder of technology and finding family and finding kin and connecting through the years. For all these many blessings, we give you thanks. Amen. Working in you that which is well-pleasing and